Hi, I'm Matthew Palco, a program manager in the enterprise and security team.
And I'm Ravi Venapusa, a program manager in the Azure AD team. In a previous video, we covered the different deployment models for Windows Hello for Business and how it is provisioned on a device. In this video, we will cover how Windows Hello for Business is used to log on and access resources.
To quickly recap, Windows Hello for Business supports cloud-only, on-premise-only, and hybrid deployments. In all these configurations, a user will provision a private public key pair as their credential that is protected by a simple user gesture, a PIN, a face, or a fingerprint. If the user only has the key as their credential, we refer to this configuration as key trust. If they also have a certificate issued from their company's public key infrastructure, we refer to it as certificate trust. Using Hello for Business as a credential can be broken down into two main flows: authentication to Azure Active Directory and authentication to Active Directory. These two flows can occur during logon or when trying to access a specific resource. Ravi, can you explain how Windows Hello for Business works on Azure AD join devices?
Sure. Almost all authentication scenarios in Windows start with a credential provider, and Windows Hello for Business is no different. On the lock screen, credential providers are represented by small square icons showing the user their available authentication options. In the case of Windows Hello for Business, credential providers will be used to collect the user's PIN, face, or fingerprint. When a user provides their gesture to the appropriate credential provider, it will verify that the gesture matches one registered by the user. If the gesture is correct, the credential provider will get back a ticket from the Windows Hello service that can be redeemed for a signature operation. This ticket is passed to WinLogon, which essentially loads the credential providers and is also responsible for loading the user profile after a successful logon. WinLogon will then pass the credentials to the local security authority, or LSA for short, which will complete the authentication process. During authentication to Azure AD, the LSA will leverage a component called the Cloud Authentication Security Support Provider, or Cloud AP for short, to communicate with Azure AD. The LSA will pass the ticket from Windows Hello to Cloud AP. When Cloud AP receives them, it will request a cryptographic nonce from Azure AD. This is an arbitrary random number that is used to ensure that old authentications to Azure AD can't be reused. Cloud AP will request that the Windows Hello for Business stack sign the nonce with the user's private key that was provisioned during registration. The signed nonce will be returned by Cloud AP to Azure AD, which will use the public key that the user registered during provisioning to confirm that the nonce was indeed signed by the correct private key. A register key was used. Azure will generate a primary refresh token, or PRT, for the user and send it back to the device. The PRT will be cached by the LSA so that it can be used in future authentication requests to Azure AD and also enable single sign-on to any Azure AD resources. Now, the LSA will notify WinLogon that authentication occurred successfully, and WinLogon will load the user's profile. The user will land on the desktop and can access any cloud resources that they need to get their things done using the PRT alone. One important note to make about authenticating to Azure with Windows Hello for Business is that a certificate is never involved. This authentication is purely key-based, even in cases where a user has been issued a Windows Hello for Business certificate. Now, let's take a look at how Windows Hello authentication works on a hybrid Azure AD join device. Matthew, can you explain how the authentication works on hybrid Azure AD join devices?
Sure. In this scenario, the logon flow is going to differ from an Azure AD joined one because the primary identity provider for this device is on-premise AD. These devices need to authenticate to a domain controller in order to log in and access on-premise resources. The same is true of domain join devices, where there is no Azure AD presence. For hybrid Azure AD join devices, the logon flow will look very similar to traditional smart card authentication to a domain controller and will use the Kerberos protocol. Windows Hello for Business will package its authentication request to the domain controller the same way Windows would package a smart card authentication request. This flow starts the same as the Azure AD join case, where a credential provider will collect one of the user's Windows Hello for Business gestures and verify it with the Windows Hello service. It will get back a ticket from the service and pass it down to the local security authority. In the on-premises case, because we want to authenticate to the domain controller with Kerberos instead of Azure AD, the ticket is passed to a component called the Kerberos provider instead of Cloud AP. The Kerberos provider will use a domain hint to locate a domain controller that will act as the key distribution center, or KDC, role in the Kerberos protocol. It will use the ticket it got to then sign Kerberos pre-authentication data with the user's Windows Hello for Business private key. The provider then sends the signed pre-authentication data to the domain controller along with a certificate for the user's Windows Hello for Business public key and a message known as an ASREC. This message is specific to the Kerberos protocol and contains information needed to properly complete the authentication.
So Matthew, what you explained was key trust. How is it going to be different in CertTrust?
In the case of a certificate trust deployment, the certificate provided in the AS rec will be a user certificate issued to the user by their enterprise's public key infrastructure. If they are using KeyTrust instead, the certificate will be a self-signed certificate generated by the system. When the domain controller receives the AS rec, it will attempt to validate the certificate provided in the request. For certificate trust, the DC will be able to validate this because the certificate chains to a trusted root certificate authority. It will retrieve the public key and user principal name from the cert, and it can then validate the signature over the pre-auth data using the public key and verify that the UPN in the cert is also an Active Directory. In the case of KeyTrust, the certificate is self-signed, and it doesn't chain to a trusted root. If the domain controller sees that the certificate is self-signed, it will look up the public key in the certificate in AD and validate that this is registered to the user who's attempting to authenticate. The DC trusts that the user authenticated and MFA'd when the key was registered, and it will use that to validate the signature over the pre-auth data. The logic to handle looking up the public key and trusting that it was registered properly was added to Windows Server 2016, which is why KeyTrust requires 2016 or newer domain controllers in your environment. Once the domain controller confirms the validity of the AS rec, it will generate a ticket granting ticket, or TGT, which can be used for future authentication requests to the KDC. That gets sent back to the client in another Kerberos message called an AS rep. The Kerberos provider on the client also needs to verify that the message it received is valid. It will use the KDC certificate, which was included in the AS rep, to do this. The Kerberos provider will verify the KDC certificate chains to a trusted root and that it is for the correct domain that the user is trying to authenticate to. It will then pass the TGT to the local security authority, which will then cache it for future authentication requests from the client. For future authentication to on-premise resources, the TGT can be used without the user having to provide a gesture, giving them SSO to any on-premise resources. LSA will then notify WinLogon of the successful authentication, which will load the user's profile and allow them onto the desktop. The same flow that was used to log in on an Azure AD device also happens on a hybrid Azure AD join device, and this is usually going to happen immediately following this logon flow that I just went through.
One important thing to remember is that in the case of an Azure AD join device, this on-premises authentication flow happens on demand when a user is trying to access an on-prem resources. So on-premises authentication can work even if the device itself is not joined to on-premises Active Directory, as the credential is a user attribute. That's it for authentication for Windows Solo for Business to both Azure AD and on-premises AD. Whether using key or certificate trust, a user should be able to authenticate to Azure AD and on-premises AD if your infrastructure is configured properly. This will result in a user getting a PRT and a TGT, which enable seamless access to both cloud and on-prem resources. I hope this was helpful for you to understand how Windows Solo for Business works in both provisioning and authentication.
Thanks for joining us. For more information, please take a look at our documentation at aka.ms/whfb.